Chef Steven welcoming you to this episode of Fritos Pie Remix. That's where we take the classic Fritos pie and an extreme ingredient and mix it up to create a whole new favorite. Today's extreme ingredient is crawfish, also known as crayfish, also known as crawdad, used in New Orleans style cooking. And my mother always said I was destined to be a saint. Who dat? Well, let's get started with our Fritos pie. We're gonna take the crawfish meat and we're gonna make what I call a crawfish etouffee Fritos pie. Etouffee is fancy talk, it's French. It means to smother. And how perfect to make a Fritos pie, because Fritos pie started with smothering chili over Fritos pie. So let's get started making a crawfish etouffee Fritos pie. Okay, we're gonna get started making our crawfish etouffee Fritos pie. I have a hot pan. I'm gonna add some canola oil and let that heat up. Then I'm gonna add what's called the holy trinity of Cajun cooking, and that is onions, bell peppers, and celery. We want to saute those until they're tender. It's going to take about 4 minutes. Now that our vegetables are cooked down and tender, I'm going to add some garlic. All right, now I want to add with the garlic our Cajun spices. Make sure you get a good Cajun blend that has herbs in it. And then we're going to add a butter. This butter that I added is, you'll see that it's a little pink, because what we did is we made a crawfish butter as we enhance it with cooked crawfish shells. You can find recipes for it in cookbooks and on the internet, or you could just use regular plain butter. Now the flour, and then it's used as a thickening agent. I wanted to do this simply in one pot, so you'll see, don't be scared that there's some residue in the bottom of the pan. What we're doing is we're cooking out the flour flavor, and we're also toasting some of the milk solids that are in the butter, and then darkening the flour to a nutty flavor that gives you the qualities of a dark roux. Now I'm gonna use a little bit of chicken broth, and you wanna add it a little at a time, and then you'll see how it'll deglaze the bottom of the pan, and it'll start to thicken. When it thickens, add a little more. If you add it all at one time, you're likely to get clumps, and you don't want that. All right, and then a little more. So if you get a block of frozen crawfish, you can drain out the liquid, and that can be part of the cooking liquid for your etouffee. That goes in, crawfish go in, and then we let that thicken up, and we let the flavors mingle. See how that's coming together quite nicely? So let's get started building our crawfish etouffee Fritos pie. I have our Fritos pie bowl filled with Fritos Original. And I'm gonna take the wonderful crawfish etouffee, pour that evenly over the top. Beautiful. A little bit of green onions for color and flavor. And that, my friends, is a crawfish etouffee Fritos pie. That concludes this episode of Fritos Pie Remix. Remember, you can go to our website and submit your idea for an extreme ingredient, and you just might see it on a future episode. So bring it on.